coronary calcium scan is an increasingly popular procedure for the early detection of coronary atherosclerosis. And the purpose of the test is to detect and treat coronary artery disease and vascular disease before it causes a clinical problem like a stroke or a heart attack. We know that there are people walking around with heart disease, but like an iceberg, a lot of what happens with heart disease happens below the surface. And if you don't look for it, you won't find it. The traditional testing that we've done, like stress testing, has a lot of deficiencies. For example, a 50% blocked artery would not show up on a treadmill test or a stress test, but you would see it on a coronary calcium score test. And even though that plaque is not causing problems now, it may cause a serious problem in the near future. So the aggressive treatment of patients with asymptomatic atherosclerotic heart disease and vascular disease is really the goal of the coronary calcium score. By scoring the patient's calcium, you can estimate the amount of plaque that they have in their arteries even before it's causing any symptoms. And it's been validated that the higher your calcium score, the higher your risk of a future heart attack or stroke. We think the value of that test is that it makes patients aware that they have heart disease before any damage can be done, so they can become much more vigilant about risk factors such as smoking, blood pressure, and cholesterol. I'm a big believer in the aggressive treatment of asymptomatic coronary disease, including the use of cholesterol-lowering medications, blood thinners, and supplements prior to them having a problem. Coronary calcium scoring is probably best applied to people in the middle somewhere. So if you've already had bypass surgery or a stent, a coronary calcium score is not going to do you very much good. On the other end of the spectrum, if you're a 19-year-old woman or a 25-year-old man with no other risk factors, a coronary calcium score is very likely to not be very helpful. However, if you have at least one or two coronary risk factors and you're over the age of 35, then the test can be worthwhile in delineating what your risk is, not only because you get a score, but you also get a score compared to other people your age and gender, so you can decide whether or not you have more plaque in your arteries than somebody else in your age group. And that can be a real wake-up call for some people. On the other hand, if your calcium score comes back zero, that's also very reassuring for those people who are worried about the status of their heart or maybe some symptoms that they're having.